You are watching another TV with the brand new Sony Xperia E smartphone. Inside this little bag, of course, there's something else also inside, which I unboxed actually before, but you have to, I think, check out the videos here on the... I think it's on this side, but maybe it's on the other side, depending on which way the video is showing, actually, at you at home and on YouTube. So, Bluetooth speaker, that's something you will get here when you buy this little Sony Xperia E on contract. Maybe even in the States or in the UK you will have the same, but actually let's just take a closer look at the Sony Xperia E. Since this is a quite beautiful, cheap smartphone, which has actually everything inside that you might want, like a camera on the back, which has 3 megapixels, that's totally enough. 1 GHz single core processor, it's fast for Jelly Bean, you will see. 3.5 inch display, so it's as big as an iPhone 4, so it doesn't need so much battery. And the battery is actually 1500 milliamps. I think there is NFC inside, but there's no logo on here, but I mean, when they are bundling it with an NFC speaker, that would kind of make sense. On the back, you can see here, actually, there is a black and a golden one. I have the black one inside the box, even though I know it says, or it shows a golden side, but actually, on the bottom here, it says black, and also C1605. So, yeah, what else is there to show on the box? Actually, nothing, so let's take a look inside. This is what you will get. First thing is first, the smartphone itself. Let's just put it on the table, since there is of course a few other things inside, like for example micro USB cable. That's something you will need maybe every day if you want to charge it every day, but I don't think that you need to. Actually, then we have a little charger inside, which gives out 850 milliamps at 5 volts. This is of course the European version. There will be, or the UK one might even not have one inside, since in the UK sometimes they don't give you one, since that's better for the environment. But USB and headphones, not in ear, just a standard, not golden end, but or not tip, not a golden tip, but I mean, for a cheap smartphone that's all right. And then we have one button to answer your calls and cancel your calls, and only one microphone inside there. Then we have some pamphlets, not too much, a setup guide, SAR information, FCC statement, and warranty. And there is also battery actually inside, but I already put it inside the smartphone so we can go on faster. So, as I said, 1500 milliamps. And I will take off the back and show that to you also in a second. So, we have here the smartphone itself. You can see quite beautiful, rubberish back. Feels also quite sturdy. You cannot really bend it. We have again 3.5 megapixel camera with no flash. 3.5 millimeter headphone jack on top, on the bottom some speakers on the back. I don't know what this hole is actually here for, since this is nothing for a strap, otherwise it would have on the front also a hole. What I didn't mention, what you can actually see on the box, is that we have a little status LED here on the bottom, or LED that shows you a little bit of ambi light, you could say. On the top there's actually another status LED which is a little bit more decent, which is actually blinking red right now since the battery is almost dead. We have no camera on the front. On the sides, this new button look by Sony for 2013, you could call it a nipple. You have not seen this last year, for example with the Sony Xperia T you have just a regular button, now you have these nipples on the Z, ZL and everything else. You have a dedicated camera button, even though just 2 megapixels volume rocker, which looks kind of weird right now, since the bottom part is sticking out a little bit more than the top. I don't know what happened there. And micro USB on this side. Now, as I said, you can just flip the back or switch the back off like this. Actually, check out. There we go. So, we have the 1500 milliamp battery, which has 5.6 watt hours. Micro SD card reader, and is actually the dual Sony Xperia E. So it has dual SIM. There's also single SIM available, but this has two SIM slots. It's quite nice if you have a Mexican and a American SIM card, for example, or in my case, Hungarian and German, and you don't want to carry around two smartphones with you, and the battery life is actually not that bad still when you use it like that. So let me put it back on. Just slide it in like that. Press the on key. Slide here to the left, right, and The sun is shining. This is maximum brightness right now, but I cannot see much of the screen. And now I selected the wrong language, so I have no clue what the display says now. But I tried to show to you that it's actually quite fast. You can just hit the middle button here on the bottom, and then you can see here all the apps, or maybe not see. Let me check again if this is the maximum brightness, because before it looked a little bit better. Now I don't understand anything, but I know where I have to press everything, so it's all right. There we go. So maximum brightness still. It's fast, you will see it in my complete review. What I will do now is of course press the camera button, so you can see that the camera turns on quite quickly, and actually it's also quick enough. Well, okay, not much to see there since it's too bright out here, but a lot of smartphones, even my Samsung Galaxy S3, has that problem. So if I already have here the Xperia T in my hand, let's compare it in size. Not really fair, but you can see, of course, these are the two smartphones. Triple the price. Samsung Galaxy S3, I won't even show it since I have the battery pack on here right now. But there is a similar priced one with a 5 megapixel camera, a little bit bigger screen. The ZTE Blade 3, I can actually also recommend that. Quite a good smartphone. You can see here, of course, bigger screen. Makes the device a little bit bigger, but otherwise, they are, I think, in price about the same. Thickness. Here you go. What else do I have here? Of course, Apple iPhone 5. Again, not fair, since this is actually maybe even an Apple iPhone 4 or 3G in terms of hardware. But now you can see 4-inch to 3.5-inch. Here's the comparison. And in terms of thickness again, here we go. So thank you much for watching. This was the short unboxing, hands-on and comparison with the Sony Xperia E. I hope you liked it. If you did, please subscribe right here on the bottom. Thank you much for watching at Devil TV. There will be of course a full review coming up soon. And if you like other gadgets like the Bluetooth speaker I showed you in the beginning and so on, please also don't forget to subscribe and check out our other videos. We have over 3,000 of them in our channel. Till next time, my name is Balazs Gal, thank you much for watching.